Hi everyone, and welcome to the next lecture, which will be on database model queries. Okay, so we are basically going to query our records in our SQLite database. So before we can actually query them, we just want to make a few records. We just want to perhaps make some more. If we don't have any, we're just going to go ahead and add it. So let's head over to our admin page. So we're manually going to create a few records or objects, you could say. So let's go ahead and do that. So let's see. Okay, so we're not going to deal with our review model. We're just going to add tasks for now in this place. So I'm just going to add a task, and here I'm going to say finish chores at finish daily chores. And then here I can say must be done by 11 a.m. Save that record. Okay, let's add another one. Next one I'm going to say complete Django tutorial series. Remember to talk about model queries. Okay. And I'm going to add one more, another task. So you can give it any task that you'd like. Here I'm going to say, remember to take a break. And then here I'm going to say, take a break. All right, and save. Okay, so we have three objects, three task objects in our task model here. Of course, we can see here task object three, four, and five. So we have three records, you could say. Okay, perfect. Now, if we go, if we go back to Django, what we want to do is we just want to go to our templates, index.html, and there's for loop here. Okay, we want to remove this data because we want to manipulate, of course, more dynamic data since it'll be from a database. Of course, this was, you could say, hand coded. So if we go to our views, it's from here. So we can, what we can do is we can just go ahead and take this out, take out the context, and we can delete this list. Client list was ordered to dictionaries for now, and we can go ahead and remove this for loop here for now. So we have this. So let's delete that. Okay, let's just close everything up here just to be clean. All right, and we can now go and check on our localhost page here. And we can see here all that data is gone. So now we're going to be rendering it from our database. So we manually created records in Django admin to our SQLite database manually. Instead of creating it, like for example, creating a form here and submitting data, we manually created it. And that is because I want to show you basically how database queries would work. So how we would query our Django models. So what we can do is we can go ahead back to our views.py, and here under our home tab, we are going to write a query. So first of all, we need to make use of our model. Okay, so we're going to make use of our task model. So we can go here and we can say from.models. And remember, the reason that we say dot is because that file models.py is in the same directory as our views.py. So we can say from models import task. Okay, so now we can make use of this model. Now, first thing I want to show you is how to select all the objects from a table. So from, we want to select all the objects basically from our task model or task database table. And to do that, we can just assign a variable here. So I'm going to say query all data. You can give it any name you want, doesn't really matter. And here we need to say task.objects.all. Okay, so we can see here, we're saying task, this is our model, and we want to get all the objects. So we're using the all message here to retrieve all the objects in our task model. So what we can do next is we can simply set this up in a context dictionary. So it would be very straightforward. We would say context. And here we can give the key as let's say tasks, and I'm going to put here the value. So it's going to be the value of all the objects as our value here, and I'm going to say query all data. Perfect. Now we assign our context dictionary here to context, which is perfect. And now we want to render all of our objects from our task model into our HTML template, which is on index.html. So we're going to use pretty much the same logic we've done the whole before. So we can go ahead and create a tag here. So we say for, and let's see what we have, called tasks. So we can say for tasks. So we can choose our own name here. We can call it anything we want in tasks. So that would be this key here. We're referencing that key. Close the tag. And I just want to go ahead and just say end for. And here we can do the same that we've done before. I should have actually kept that code from before, but that's not a problem. So I can just copy this twice. That's good. Okay, that's fine. And I'm just simply going to put a line break here. And here, that's good. And we can just separate this. And here we can render out our actual attributes. So under the attributes, we have a title and a content attribute. We also have date posted, but we're just going to, for now, just keep it with title and content, just so you understand how this works. So we can just say task.title. I always like to leave a space here. So this is referencing our task in tasks, which of course is referencing to our value that we have here, which is all the tasks in the model object. So we can then put here, okay, we can put task.content. And I remember I forgot a percentage symbol there, good. So let's of course make indent this a bit so it's a bit cleaner. So we have task and title, task.content. And what we want to do is we want to go ahead and of course refresh our browser. So what I like to do is just cancel the server and run it again. And we can go ahead and refresh. And there we go. So we can see all of our objects being output. Okay. Now what we can try and do is we can also, you know, we can make this a bit nicer. So I just want to add a few lines here so it looks a little bit better. Okay, there's a little bit more space here. Let's set the content like this. Okay, so everything is separated. So we can see here, we basically have three objects here. Now, what we can also do is we can go ahead and add the ID as well. So let's do that. So the ID, Django automatically assigns it for us. So we don't need to take care of this. So it's automatic. So we can see here, this is object ID 3, 4, and 5. Okay, number 1 and 2, if you recall, we deleted those. So this is how we would, of course, output all of our data from our SQLite database using, of course, our objects.all query here. All right, so that is how we would select all the data. Right, so let's say we don't want to select all the data and we only want to select one particular object, okay? So to do that, we can just, I'm just going to change this name here. So I'm going to say query single object. So here I'm going to say query single object. And here I can just say get. And I want to get a specific instance. So I want to get something where the ID is equal to 3, okay? And what I can do, I can go here, and we're not going to loop out, okay? We don't need to do that. We can remove our end for here, and our for, we can remove our for loop. And of course, we can't just simply keep our attributes here, because the attribute is going to be the same, but we're only referencing, going to reference one unique record in our database. Right, so before we can go further, I just want to add another space here. And this is not going to work because, of course, we need to reference by our key here. So it's tasks. So I'm just going to add an S here, but that wouldn't make sense. So let's replace this to task now. Since we're not using our for loop, this is okay. So we are referencing, this will be our key now, and we're not looping out. We're just going to get one particular record or instance, like I mentioned. So if we go back and we refresh, oh, it's already there. And we can see here that specific instance. So let's say we want to go back and we want to get ID5. So we would go back, refresh, and it would specifically get that unique record. Okay, so hopefully you've learned something in this tutorial. So what we've been through is I was just teaching you how to work with database queries. So this is how you'll perform a query on a Django model. So you learned two methods. You learned how to get all objects using the all method. Okay, and you also learned how to get a specific instance by using the get method. Okay, so that's it.